The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples had forgotten to bring bread, and they had only one loaf with them in the boat. Jesus enjoined them, "Watch out, guard against the leaven of the Pharisees and the leaven of Herod." They concluded among themselves that it was because they had no bread. When he became aware of this, he said to them, "Why do you conclude that it is because you have no bread? Do you not yet understand or comprehend? Are your hearts hardened? Do you have eyes and not see, ears and not hear? And do you not remember when I broke the five loaves of the five for the 5,000? How many weaker baskets full of fragments you pick up?" They answered him, 12. "When I broke the seven loaves for the 4,000, how many full baskets of fragments did you pick up?" They answered him, 7. He said to them, "Do you still not understand?" The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat, and welcome to the Minor Basilica of Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag. Lahat naman ho tayo dumaan sa elementary days or kinder or nursery to some. And I remember very much, pagka umuwi after class, kasalubong na yung lolo ko. At ang tatanungin ay, anong natutunan? What did you learn today? And I would recount. If it's mathematics, I would do some multiplication. If it's about geography, I would tell him about the places that were taught to us during the day. I'm sure ganun din yung mga magulang dito. Pagka umuwi yung mga anak ninyo, you ask the question, anong natutunan? What have you learned? You see, to a teacher, it is very important na may natututunan sa kanila yung kanilang mga estudyante. Dito po sa community namin, sa Our Lady of the Rosary of Manaoag, the Dominican community, we have the joy and the privilege of living with some of our professors at the University of Santo Tomas. Kasama na po namin sila dito, lolo na, and we get to tease them ng mga pagkakataon na pinatayo kami dahil hindi makasagot, hindi makatranslate from Latin to English, at bali-bali yung grammar, pinapaspelling sa amin yung mga words na akala namin ay alam namin yung spelling. And we get to tease them. But one of the lolo said to us, actually yesterday, when I teased him again about that, ang sabi niya, "At least may natutunan kayo." Totoo nga naman, no? Sa isang teacher, it is very important na nakikita mo na yung estudyante mo ay may natututunan. And to a teacher, it is a joy. Kaya nga napakahirap maintindihan kapag kami mga teachers na nagre-rejoice na, babagsak ito. Bumagsak nga, no? Limang bumagsak sa akin. Minsan, nagbibilang pa yan, no? And I don't know if they are aware that it is a reflection of the kind of teaching sometimes kapag maraming bumabagsak. It reflects on the teacher. Kaya nga, in the gospel that we read today, our Lord being the good teacher is frustrated and is feeling pain because after so long a time that the disciples and apostles were with him, they still did not learn. They still did not understand. After everything, parang sinasabi ng Panginoon, after you have heard my preaching, after you have seen the miracles I made in front of you and you were there, and after you have partaken of these miracles, experience it them yourselves, hindi nyo pa rin maintindihan. do you still not understand? No? Yun yung last sentence. Siguro sinasabi ng Panginoon, wala naman kayong learning disability, wala naman kayong dyslexia, wala naman kayong mga problem sa pag-iisip. No? So wala naman kayong learning disability. But learning problem, maaaring meron. It is not a learning problem na walang resources, walang access. Ando na nga sila eh, kaharap na. The fount of all wisdom is the one that's speaking to them at every moment. Ando na, makikinig na lang. No? Ando na, no? Na lang nila kung ano man yung sinasabi ng Panginoon sa buhay nila. And yet, do you still not understand? Marami po sa atin ngayon ay merong ganong learning problem. Yung learning problem na gusto mag-aral, hindi makapag-aral kasi walang access, walang resources. Pero excited na excited, matuto. Kaya nga perhaps we can understand na they might be lacking in understanding. Walang access eh, walang resources. But that's not what the apostles and then the disciples are in. So wala silang ganoong learning problem. The Lord also warned the apostles about another learning problem. Hindi yung want, but the learning problem nitong mga Pharisees. Ano yung learning problem na yun? Because they are so full of themselves that they could no longer accept the new teaching ng ating Panginoon. They are so satisfied with what they know. They are already self-sufficient about what they have learned that there is no room for the teaching of the Lord. It's scary because this is a fullness that can lead to arrogance, because this is a fullness, the fullness of themselves. Punong-puno ng sarili nila. Ng sarili nila, kaya hindi na makakita. Kaya sarado na yung isip. At nakakatakot kapag ganoon, sapagkat when you are full of ng sarili, it leads to arrogance and it leads to closeness, pagiging sarado ng pag-iisip. So what is it that the Lord accuses the disciples and apostles that they still do not understand? Kapag pinakinggan niyo po ng maigi yung Ebanghelyo, the Lord recounted the events and the things, particularly in the miracle, the multiplication of the loaves, sapagkat they concluded na, uy, nakalimutan na naman natin yung tinapay, kaya siguro tayo pinapagalitan. And then the Lord knows what they were thinking, and He realized that they failed to understand what He has been teaching them all along. They missed the point. They missed the point. And what is that? That they've been with the Lord who is the Lord of abundance. Of the Lord na hindi kukulangin. Sobra. Kaya nga, anong rinecount niya? Binilangan sila, no? When I conducted this miracle, ilan ang sobra? Nag-multiply ako ng ganito, ilang basket yung sobra? No? And still you do not understand that I am the Lord of abundance? Na kapag ka sa akin, everything will be sufficient. Today in the gospel, the same question is also being asked of all of us. There are two things that we can look at our lives from the perspective ng ating Panginoon sa mata ng abundance. At kapag ka sa mata ng abundance, na hindi tayo kukulangin, it is from that perspective and perks that we look at our lives and everything that is happening sa buhay natin, mas madaling maging generous. Hindi naman kukulangin eh. Lagi namang andyan ang ating Panginoon. Everything will be sufficient. It's easy to be generous. Pero oras that we see deficit, we see kakulangan, we see na mauubos, we see na konti na lang, that's dangerous also because it leads to greed. The Lord, in the gospel that we read today, is asking us the question, how do you look at the things that are happening in your life? From the perspective of abundance, sufficiency, because the Lord is a God of abundance and sufficiency, or from the perspective na kulang, wala, deficit. Scary yung dulo. One thing that I learned, again, from our lolo professor is that mahirap magbilang ng wala. Kasi daw, pag nagbilang ka ng wala, nakakabuang. Magsimula ka magbilang kung anong wala ka sa buhay mo ngayon. Walang malaking bahay, walang siguradong trabaho, walang magandang asawa, walang matinong asawang lalaki. Ang daming wala. Natapos na misa natin, hindi pa tapos yung pagbibilang nyo ng wala. But the moment daw na magbilang tayo ng meron, ngumingiti ka habang dumadami yung nare-realize mo kung ano yung meron ka, because our God is a God of abundance. So my dear friends, do you still not understand?